Good morning, Moreland. Happy Monday, August 30th, 2021. Welcome back to school on this Monday morning. It is supposed to be a little dreary. It is a day cycle 6 on the day cycle calendar, which means you might be going to a special you haven't seen or visited last week. So that's kind of exciting, although a little dreary outside. It is a good day to be in school. There's always a reason to be positive, and it's just awesome to be back with you today. Happy Monday. What an awesome day to be together. I hope you had a great weekend. I hope you enjoyed some time outside. It wasn't super hot. I thought it was a pretty decent weekend, especially yesterday morning. Got a little humid as the day went on, but overall I thought it was great. I hope you took some time to relax. I hope you took some time to breathe, and I hope that you are ready to go this week. There are no birthdays today. Today's lunch and breakfast. Breakfast today is the cherry frutal. Tomorrow's breakfast is the mini pancakes. So if you're getting breakfast today, you're eating the frutal. Tomorrow's breakfast is the pancakes. Today's main lunch is the classic chicken sandwich, and the alternate is the nacho fun lunch. So choice one is the chicken sandwich, and choice two, or the alternate, is the nacho fun lunch. So I hope you are all ready to go this week. Our word of the week is hanging behind me, behind my head, their expectation. We're not going to talk about that too much anymore. Those expectations, like I said in the assembly on Friday, should be getting into your head and something that you were just remembering, something that you're just following because you're supposed to. This week's word is a good one, especially for the second week. But we can talk about it all year long as well. But it's a really important one to talk about at the beginning of the year. This week's word is stamina. Stamina. You might have heard the word stamina from Mr. Growla in gym class, because when we talk about sports, we talk about your physical stamina and how long you can do something, how much endurance or how much strength can you endure. So stamina is how long you can do something, how long you can in school, in reading class, how long you can read. In math class, how long you can do and tend to math problems. In class, how long can you tend to your teacher's teaching or tend to your teacher's instruction? So when we talk about stamina, we're talking about how long you can do something. And that's a good one for this week because it's the second week of school and some of the excitement of the first week has worn off. You're getting a little tired. We're coming back to school 5 days, 7 hours every day. Your stamina is probably not where it should be, especially after COVID the past 2 years. We were hardly in school much last year. We had tier one, tier two. You were only here 2 days a week, home 3 days a week. So last week was exciting. This week is going to be a real test of our stamina. How long can you tend to your teacher's instruction? How long can you read? How long can you pay attention? It's not just sports, and Mr. Growla is going to talk about how long can you run, or how long can you lift weights, or how much can you do, how many flips can you do, how long can you engage in a physical activity. That's important. But we're also talking about our reading stamina, our school stamina, our math stamina. How long can you do it? And this week it's going to be challenging. It's going to challenge you to increase your stamina. You might start the year to this week with only a couple minutes of stamina, but by the end of the year, we really need your stamina to be good and ready to go. So you have to practice following and growing your stamina. The expectation, that word behind me, is that your stamina will improve over the course of this year. So your teachers understand that stamina right now might not be the best, but over the course of this year, it should get better. So this week's word is stamina. How much do you have? And maybe it's a goal that you get better or increase your stamina as the year goes on, especially thinking about school. Another segment I'd like to start today is a little reading segment. And I'm not going to read much, but I have a book here that is from one of my favorite soccer players, Marcus Rashford. I love Manchester United. It's my favorite soccer team. And I have a book that he wrote this summer called You Are a Champion: How to Be the Best you can be. And I'm going to read a little bit on parts of this book because I think it's a fantastic book to get you thinking about how you can be awesome, how you can be the best that you can be, that mighty Moreland motivator. Take the initiative that you're going to be working on this month in September. So I'm going to read a little bit today and a little bit every day, and hopefully we can get through this book in a reasonable amount of time. So it's by Marcus Rashford, one of my favorite soccer players from Manchester United. You are a champion. Hello, my name is Marcus Rashford. You might know me because I really, really like football. I mean, I really like football. Football is how they say soccer in England. I've supported Manchester United ever since I can remember, and I've been playing for them since 2016. It's been an incredible few years. I scored during my debut match, and the team has won some important trophies. I also play for the England team. I scored on my debut there, too, and I have been to a World Cup with them. That was an incredible experience, and I'll definitely tell you more about it later. That's not what this book is about, though. Not really. You might know me because I play football for Manchester United in England, but you might also know me for the charitable campaigns I helped organize in 2020. Together with the food charity Fair Share and the help of people up and down the country, we launched the End Child Food Poverty campaign to help make sure that millions of children all over the UK had access to the food and support they needed during the pandemic and beyond. Kind of like our initiative, Project Share initiative here at Moreland. I'm really proud of that work, too. But that's not quite what this book is about either. This book is about you. I want you to know that there are people out there who believe in you and who understand that you are the start of your life's journey, a journey that can be the most incredible thing. My journey has taken me to some really interesting places, and something I've always tried to remember is that there are no limits to what is possible in this life. I know it isn't always the easiest of journeys and that sometimes you might get stuck and need help, but you are capable of amazing things. This book right here is about you. So we're going to read how to be the best you can be throughout this, throughout the next couple of weeks to figure out how you can be the best and take some advice from Marcus Rashford. Ladies and gentlemen, that is it for today. You have a fantastic day improving, increasing your stamina. Earn those Mighty Moreland Motivator tickets. Follow the expectations in the lunchroom, wherever you are around the school, and make me proud. Make your families proud, and do your best to be the best you can be. Let's say our Moreland mantra together, and then we'll say that, and we'll listen to the national anthem followed by the pledge to the flags. Everybody, please stand, and let's say our Moreland mantra together. Believe it. Ready? I am kind. I am capable. I am valued. We are one. Stay standing for the national anthem, followed by the pledge to the flag, and have a fantastic day, Moreland.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Be the best you today, Moreland.